Get so Wally, what inspired 03 Flow? My first record I heard from you right there. That's like,
so keep it G. I was just going through some shit. I was, you know what I'm saying? I think I had just drove. I had just drove from Alabama, nigga, like 26 hours.
Mission.
And my boy, he wasn't trying to wake up and help me drive. So I'm driving. I'm thinking about the shit that just happened. I took an L.
I already know what you was on.
And then just life shit. You know, a nigga be going through shit, bro. My life was kind of hard. I ain't going to lie. Shit, growing up, that shit was tough. So I'm like, how can I make something for everybody that's like me? Like, you feel what I'm saying? So that's how that shit came about. And then my nigga Greedo was dealing with that case. So as I was doing the song, I'm like, damn, this shit kind of resonated. Like, it all makes sense. So the sound, too. The sound, you know, Greedo, he made that raunchy sound, that garage sound. I made the song in the projects.
That's all right.
In his projects?
No, I made the song in the Carmelitos.
Shout out to the Litos, man.
Yeah,
shout out Long Beach.
I pulled up to my boy house after that long ass drive, nigga. I didn't even go to sleep.
You went straight to the Litos?
I walked in his house. I walked in the house. I'm like, man, I ain't even finna go to sleep. I'm stressed out, so I gotta do something, get this shit off.
Yeah.
And that's really what happened.
Yeah, that shit. Lucky that you did that thing, because that motherfucker's a stupid record right there.
I got so much shit. Brandon the Pro. Shout out to Brandon the Pro for the beat.
Brandon the Pro. That's
but I got so much music, bro, that's like really the best shit I ever heard.
You definitely got some records for sure.
You like, know, and you said you was going through shit. You said you've gone through shit growing up, too. You know, and I've interviewed you before. A lot of motherfuckers, y'all acting like y'all memory is just gone. But that's okay. Y'all should erase a lot of the shit I've done over there at that other platform. So fuck it. You know what I mean? We can start over and do it up. But I did have Wally with me.
They roasting the fuck out of me.
That nigga
said Wally look like what bad kids get for Christmas.
That's funny,
nigga. Cash out that nigga $2.
Fuck you niggas. Y'all niggas gonna give me this super chat. We gonna read them two later, man. But I do wanna, you know what I'm saying, let the people know how you kinda grew up. For those that don't know, cause you know it was some shit that kinda resonated with me when you said you used to just be in the park all day, all night.
Oh yeah,
you know what
shit.
I'm saying? Sleep at the park.
When a house foreclosed in the hood, I was sleeping at Gonzales Park. Like the old Jungle Gym before they built that new one, nigga. I used to have like the small bottle of what I used to have. I think it was Taka Vodka, nigga. I had a small. I used to get like a pint of Taka Vodka. Because you know that shit keep you warm when it's cold.
I wasn't drinking Taka Vodka.
Nigga, I used to be on that Jungle Gym, nigga, hitting that Taka Vodka, trying to stay warm. But
how old was you doing during that time?
Probably like 13.
God damn,
that's wild.
Hell yeah! Like they used to put the for sale sign up on my house, nigga. I used to go every time they put it up and rip that motherfucker out the dirt and throw it on the roof.
Golly, bro, that's crazy, though.
Was your whole family there, or was just that was just you in an abandoned?
No, I used to do that because my peoples moved out the hood and I didn't want to go.
Okay.
So you feel me? I'm like, I'm staying. Feel me? Y'all go ahead. Shit, I'll be over here.
You a real one for that. You said, I ain't leaving. I'm staying
but
here.
But 14, though.
What did you like, what was that process like until you got into like an adult and shit? Like, what was you doing in that time period?
Nigga, everything I could. Robbing the shit out of niggas. Snatching chains. Like, I don't know. Nigga, I used to be on that fucking train, nigga, every day looking for somebody to hit. You know what I'm talking about? But I ain't gonna make it sound like I'm not just the darkest nigga in the world. Like I still had some positivity to myself. Like
you throughout had to survive,
the whole,
though.
Yeah, throughout the whole shit. But I just was a robbing ass nigga. Yeah. I be thinking like I know niggas be watching my videos. Like man, fuck that nigga. Hey, I know they be looking at me like this.
I met this nigga. Where you know this nigga from, bro?
Nigga robbed me on the train.
Now this nigga famous now.
Right. Like, they can be proud of you too, though.
Whoever robbed you, I had to. Yeah. Right, I'm sorry.
Damn, homie, just saying it like straight up.
I had to, like that, I'm sorry.
But even though, do that kind of give you anxiety too? That you now you a known face in the land.
When and I first you, started,
and,
yeah.
And you know, you doing
nigga,
shit.
Nigga, I used to be paranoid as a bitch.
Yeah.
Hey, because like, if you pull up somewhere, everybody know who you is before you can scan the crowd.
Yeah, that's the tricky part. That's the tricky part.
You feel me?
Shit.
So I used to be paranoid as a motherfucker.
Wally, what's up? Wally.
Did I fuck your bitch? Did I rob you? All right, nice to meet you, my nigga.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, golly. I mean, I mean that shit should give you some type of anxiety. I mean, you fucking normal because the shit that we've been through, the shit that we've done, even though at kids, like you said, at 14, like, I don't know, like, what the fuck I was doing or how that made a motherfucker feel or how I affected some people's life. So, you never fucking know, homie. Like, and it probably is some niggas looking at this shit every day like, that's that bitch ass nigga right there.
Yeah.
Bitch ass nigga. But shit, I mean, shit, we live and we learn, though. But that shit did resonate with me. I'm like, this my nigga said he was in a park, nigga, all night. Used to sleep in that motherfucker. I was like, I know your homies is like, nigga, why you at that motherfucker on Bloods? We going in the motherfucker. We good on Palm Room, nigga. He gonna be there at 8 a.m.
Damn, that's sick, though.
But
for
that's
sure,
sick,
sure.
though, to be going through do. That, though. At a young age, though, you never know how good you got it out here, bro. You never know how good you got it out here.
Because I was on that for a while, nigga, for a long time, nigga. I was out there thugging, but shit, I could say some of it was just by stupid choice. Like, a nigga just wasn't used to nothing else, so I wasn't, like, I stayed in Watts growing up, but you know, you like to stay in your area.
So, looking in hindsight, then, would you done it different? Would you have left with your people?
Hell no.
Would you have still chose the way you did
it? Nah, because nigga, everything that I was doing, like, really played a part in becoming who
you
I
are
am.
Today,
like,
for sure.
Like, nigga, I be looking at some people and I be like, damn, like, nigga, you ain't been through shit. And it shows, like, like, because a lot of people ain't smart because they ain't been through shit.
That's
like,
a fact.
I really got to know people and myself. Like, most of the people I know is because, nigga, I was roaming the streets all the time, but it all came back full circle at some point. Like, damn, I knew this nigga from that, and now we both doing this.
Mm-hmm.
Or like, you know what I'm saying?
You know, that's
like
dope.
That
shit do be dope to see that type of shit for sure.
You definitely be needing them life experiences, though.
For sure. That's what makes you who you is.
Yeah. No, especially in this music industry, though.
Yeah.
Because if you getting this bitch green, oh.
It's over. Cancel Christmas.
They'll kill you.
Yeah, and I think just having real life experiences, it just make your music doper.
Yeah, you know, because some niggas, they be like, my wife wanted a divorce. Doom.
Your word.
That ain't my fault for that. Nigga go through one thing, he gonna end it all.
Mm-hmm.
Motherfuckers do. And these niggas really going to jail out here. These niggas really saying what they, these niggas doing what they rapping about.
Shut up. Fuck jail.
Yeah.
That shit
is
out,
homie. Not cool.
That shit is out, homie. But even though rapping about that shit too, man, and rapping about different things niggas been been through, like, now the police trying to hold you to it, like, nah, you did that. You did it. Come up here, nigga, you guilty. You feel me? How you feel about that, being an artist, though?
I feel like that's super fucked up.
That's fucked up.
And we gotta get smarter about how we conducting ourselves, even though, like, this is a creative space. So it's not supposed to be like that, but you know what I'm saying? Ain't shit new. They gonna find a way to take a nigga to jail. No
yeah, railroad some shit.
They gonna find a way to take your ass to jail. So if you free, nigga, be grateful.
For real. You feel me, Dupree? You been to jail?
Man, respectfully, I've never been to jail.
Damn.
It's good though, man.
That's what's up. These niggas want to get up here, man. Y'all want Wally in the front seat or what?
We
want
to thing.
What thing? Oh, you heard it, man?
Don't put me up there. They going to be roasted by us even after I leave.
You know what I'm saying? They want my boy Wally in the front seat. We'll let him get the front seat. I'll take it. All right, you know what I'm saying? I'll get back there. But first, we going to see what's up with my Imperial right now. And my boy Smack Hand. You feel me? What's going on, man? Smack, he got it, man. The brand has been over there since 16 years in the game. Don't worry about nothing. They are dope because they got legal cannabis shipped straight to your dough. You feel me? In all 50 states. Man, and right now they're giving away a free 2 gram THC A Diamond infused pre-roll with every order. You feel me? Each pre-roll comes with 1.5 grams of top shelf flower, 0.5 grams of pure THC diamond, and reusable glass tip. You feel me? So do it up. You feel me? Because this nigga gonna smoke the goddamn room out. Golly, that's why I opened the fucking door. Open the door for me.
Fuck you,
man.
G.